all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long.
Welcome, my name is Russell Martin. I'm the President and CEO of LifeNet4Families. I'm here to talk to you today a little bit about our volunteer services and what our volunteers do for us. We cannot operate our facility without our volunteers. We have well over 1,000 volunteers annually that come in to help us. They help us from in the dining room, serving, helping cooking. We have one volunteer that does haircuts and does almost 300 haircuts a month for us.
We are cooking chili today. It comes in every Wednesday, donated from our Presbyterian church, who is actually serving on the line today. It is such a wonderful situation to have such heart-filled people to accommodate the clients we have here at Cooperative.
My name is Chris Polzer. I'm one of the operating directors here, and my focus is volunteers and getting a sufficient number of people to help the supplement the staff to do what we do here on a daily basis. Homelessness and hunger may never disappear in our lifetime, but we're doing our very best to, you know, alleviate it.
This building has really been a salvation. It's been like an ark of salvation.
I've been here at LifeNet4Families for 2 years, and one of the sad things I've noticed is we're having a larger number of people needing nutritious hot meals every day. We also have a lot more families coming in for emergency food boxes. We're seeing a lot of new faces, a lot of new families.
I'm here to eat and have a good day, and food is everything's good, and I'm here with my baby.
LifeNet has provided a lot of services for me and my daughter. They've helped us with food. They've helped us maintain our light bill and our water bill when we needed help the most. I have a 2-year-old daughter named Alyssa who has autism, and LifeNet4Families helped me out with her, getting services for her and feeding her as well, because feeding is difficult with a child who has autism.
We're open 365 days a year, New Year's, Christmas, Thanksgiving. We're open, we're here to feed those in need. No questions asked. If you're hungry and you need a hot, nutritious meal, get in line and we'll feed you. We also have an emergency pantry where we put together emergency food boxes. It's about $75 worth of groceries in each food box. And we put out about 4,000 food boxes every single month.
So come here and just ask a few questions. Everybody know, and they can send you to the right person, and you will get some help if you want to help yourself.
We have 2 showers, and on any given day, we're between anywhere from 40 to 60 showers a day.
And so we are indeed seeing an increased number of people in the dining room. I mean, what used to be an average of 225 to 250, we're seeing 2-3 days a week now of 300 plus people coming to eat. So that says a lot. And likewise, we're always being asked by new people to become part of our food box program. And as well, though we don't advertise it, people who are, you know, invalids or seniors that are homebound, we're continually getting phone calls for people, you know, and they can't get here, but would love to have a food box delivered.
So. You all volunteers?
It's a true story. Sammy came to my office one day, knocked on the door, had a smile on his face, and was holding something in his hand. And he said, "Mr. Russ, I want to thank you for everything that you have done for me." It's the first time I met Sammy, and I said, "Sammy, what have we done? What have I done for you?" And a big smile on his face, he said, "I was in the military. I retired from the military. I had a job with a newspaper, And I was also living in a house. Well, what happened is I lost my job from the newspaper. The home I was living in went up for foreclosure. I was renting it, so I had to leave. Before you knew it, I was sleeping in the streets behind a dumpster. He said, "Wow, Sammy, what happens if it rained or got cold?" He said, "The owner of the gas station would open the door and allow me to sleep on the floor." Well, I am so proud to say that today, Sammy has a roof over his house, he has a job, and when he opened his hand, he had $50 in it. He said, "Mr. Russ, I want to donate $50 to LifeNet4Families. If it wasn't for LifeNet4Families, I would not have survived these last 2 years." After hearing that story, I knew the great work that we do for this community. Sammy is a starfish. He's one of those individuals that we're able to throw back in the ocean and save. We have a lot of starfishes here. We have a lot of individuals that we help on day in and day out. And donations to LifeNet, whether it's clothing, whether it's hygiene products, whether it's food and or cash, goes directly to helping people like Sammy to get their life started back on their feet again.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong. Just call on me, brother.